In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Brothers and sisters, as we enter into this sacred 3 days, this Paschal Triduum of the death and resurrection of the Lord, prepare to celebrate this Mass of the Lord's Supper. Let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries worthily. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord. ever and ever.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your year calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one, and shall share in the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake in it. The lamb must be a year old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month, and then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night, they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand. You shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night, I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt. I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate, with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution." The word of the Lord.
Amen. Trích thư thứ nhất của Thánh Phaolô Tông Đồ gửi tín hữu Corinto. Anh em thân mến, phần tôi đã lãnh nhận nơi Chúa điều mà tôi đã truyền lại cho anh em. Chúa Giêsu trong đêm bị nộp, Người cầm lấy bánh và tạ ơn, bẻ ra và phán: các con hãy lãnh nhận mà ăn. Này là mình ta sẽ bị nộp vì các con. Các con hãy làm việc này mà nhớ đến ta. Cùng một thể thức ấy, sau bữa ăn tối, Người cầm lấy chén và phán: chén này là tân ước trong máu ta. Mỗi khi các con uống, các con hãy làm việc này mà nhớ đến ta. Vì mỗi khi anh em ăn bánh và uống chén này, anh em loan truyền việc Chúa chịu chết cho tới khi Chúa lại đến. Đó là lời Chúa.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything in his power and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash his disciples' feet and dry them with the towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing, you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him, And for this reason, he said, not all of you are clean. So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on, reclined at table again, he said to them, do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do. The Gospel of the Lord.
Wonderful to welcome all of you this evening as we begin this sacred Paschal Triduum to Our Lady's Cathedral for this Mass of the Lord's Supper. What we do is, in a certain sense, pattern on what has been done in other cultures and other times for millennia. In the traditional Jewish Seder Supper at Passover, the youngest child asks the question, family members gathered round, why is this night different from all other nights? And in response to the question comes the retelling of the ancient story of the faith of the Hebrew people, the story of God's mighty works. In the Jewish reckoning of time, a day runs from sunset to sunset. As the Jewish Passover begins in the evening, so with the setting of the sun tonight, the church enters into this sacred Paschal Triduum, these holy 3 days. We recall the saving events which God has worked for us in Christ. The Triduum is the solemn celebration of the Paschal mystery, the passion, the death, the resurrection of the Lord. It is the very heart and center of our Christian faith and of our liturgical year. This Triduum, these 3 days, which run through Sunday evening, like no other time of the year, invite our attentiveness and invite our wholehearted mindfulness and participation. The Mass of the Lord's Supper, which we celebrate this evening, reminds us that our faith as Catholics is rooted in the Paschal experience of the Hebrew people. In keeping with the Lord's instruction to Moses, the Hebrews marked the doorposts, the lintels of their homes, with the blood of a spotless, unblemished lamb. The angel, passing over, seeing the blood of the lamb, passed over the homes of the God's people, and they were spared. While the firstborn of the Egyptians were struck down in death. In this manner, by the blood of the Lamb, God delivered his chosen people, the Hebrews, from their cruel slavery and led them by stages into the freedom of the Promised Land. Each year, Jewish families relive this experience, this memory of divine deliverance, by sharing the Passover meal and retelling the story of God's mighty works. These dramatic events of liberation, deliverance, forged the identity and the consciousness of the Israelites as God's chosen people. In God's plan of salvation, these mighty deeds of old foreshadowed even greater works that God would reveal hundreds of years later in Christ. All that was promised in the Old Testament, the Hebrew Scriptures, all that was mysteriously present, though veiled, God fulfills and unveils in Christ. Jesus is the true spotless Lamb, whose blood establishes a new and everlasting covenant, which seals our hearts and delivers us from the slavery to sin and the power of death, a much greater deliverance than that which the Israelites experienced by the blood of the Passover lamb in Egypt and their deliverance through the Red Sea. Tonight, we focus on several aspects of this new covenant established in the blood of Christ, our Paschal sacrifice. As we recall Jesus' Last Supper with his apostles, a Passover supper, we celebrate the institution of the Holy Eucharist as the sacrament of our new covenant in the Lord Jesus. Like the Hebrews of old and the Jews who even today relive their deliverance each year in the Passover meal, the Mass is our real-time participation in Jesus' victory over sin and death. When Jesus institutes the sacrament of the Eucharist at the Last Supper, he anticipates and makes present the sacrifice of the cross and the victory of the resurrection for all time. The Mass, which we celebrate so often, and Calvary are inseparably linked together. Through every Mass, we participate in a real way, in a sacramental way, in Jesus' saving death and glorious resurrection here and now. Jesus is the eternal high priest of this new covenant, whose blood established this covenant. After Jesus took the bread, took the wine, he blessed it and gave it to his disciples at the Last Supper, saying, "Do this in remembrance of me." Jesus gave a special participation in his new and eternal covenant to the priests whom he would establish to minister this new covenant, his apostles. "Do this," he told them, thus establishing the new priesthood in Jesus, so that this mystery of redemption might be proclaimed, might be celebrated, until he comes again in glory. Through the apostles, and through the bishops and the priests who are their successors and collaborators, Jesus continues his saving work of deliverance and redemption among us. Tonight we celebrate not only the institution of the Eucharist, the Holy Mass, but that of the priesthood as well. As Jesus said to his apostles, "Do this in memory of me," thus establishing them as priests of the new covenant in his blood. Without the priesthood, there can be no sacrifice, Without the priesthood, there can be no Eucharist. Priests are ordained, after all, primarily to offer the Eucharistic sacrifice, to celebrate the Mass, and so build up the Church. As our love for the Eucharist deepens over time and we grow in our appreciation of this extraordinary, inestimable gift that has been given to us and trusted to the Church, our appreciation of the priesthood grows as well. How can we receive the gift of the Lord's body and blood in the Eucharist, therefore, without asking God to continue to pour out his grace and blessing upon the Church, to raise up new followers of Jesus, to call men to be his ministers at this altar, so that we might receive from this altar the sacred body and blood of the Lord, and they might minister to us God's grace and mercy in the sacraments. Tonight, we hear in the Gospel of St. John the continuing reflection upon the meaning of the Eucharist. St. John's Gospel gives us the most profound reflections, contemplative vision of what takes place in the Eucharist. He gives us the beautiful Bread of Life discourse, in the sixth chapter of St. John's Gospel. Jesus clearly speaks with an alarming realism about what the Eucharist means when he says, "My flesh is real food and my blood is real drink, and unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you." His hearers were, there was no mistaking for them how real he intended this image to be, because many of them followed him no more. Jesus turned to those who remained and said, "Will you too walk away?" And what did they say? "Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of everlasting life." This realism which St. John gives us in his gospel might lead us to be surprised and amazed that St. John is the only evangelist, therefore, who does not describe the institution of the Eucharist during the Last Supper, as the other three Gospels do. Instead, he describes how Jesus, during the supper, rises, takes off his cloak, picks up a towel, and washes the feet of his disciples. The act of a humble servant, indeed of a slave. This astonishing gesture is a revelation of the Father's mercy and of Jesus' ministry. It is an illustration of the way he washes our feet all through our lives. God doesn't want to destroy us or beat us down or overwhelm us, but rather he kneels to exalt us, to lift us up, to heal us. The mystery of God's greatness is understood precisely in the fact that he's willing to become small in humble service for us. Pope Benedict once wrote, "Only when power is changed from the inside and we accept Jesus and his way of life, whose whole self is there in the action of this foot washing, only then can the world be healed and people are able to live at peace with one another." End quote. Jesus humbles himself in taking on the servant's role to reveal the way of salvation and to restore our dignity. Jesus clearly demonstrates that ministry within his church, within our church, the whole of Christian life, is a service of charity. "I have given you a model to follow," he tells us in the gospel that we just heard. He said this as he washed his disciples' feet and said, "As I have done for you, so you should also do." These are intended words not just for priests, but for all of the faithful. Jesus' prophetic action at that first Eucharist, that foot washing, reveals the depth of meaning in the Eucharist as a sacrament of charity. Of charity, of giving oneself in service for others, even to the point of laying down one's life. Eucharistic spirituality, Pope Benedict wrote in his beautiful exhortation on the sacrament of charity, which is the Eucharist. He said, Eucharistic spirituality is not just participation in Mass and devotion to the Blessed Sacrament. It embraces the whole of life. End quote. The Eucharist enables us to gather up all of the concrete details and gestures and actions of our lives and fragments of our lives and to bring them and offer them as our true spiritual worship with Christ, through Christ, and in Christ in the celebration of the Holy Mass. There must be about our lives what Pope Benedict described as a Eucharistic consistency. That is a connection between what we believe as Catholics and the way we act, not just when we come to Mass, but the way we live out this Eucharistic life in all of the actions and moments of our lives. Too often with our secular mindset so influenced by the world around us, even if we profess to believe in God, we frequently act as if God does not exist. We think, we judge, we speak, we choose, we act without reference to the convictions of our faith. We don't give sufficient thought to the practical implications, the application of our faith to our public lives, our social lives, our professional family lives, our personal lives. Only when we allow ourselves to be touched and to abide in an experience of the mercy of God shared with us in the Eucharist will we manifest the joy of the gospel in our lives consistently. And so as a people who are formed by the saving death and resurrection of the Lord and given a share in his royal priesthood, our lives ought to be marked with the same paschal character. This willingness to serve one another, to wash one another's feet, to live out the mystery of the Eucharist in our daily lives consistently. Tonight, we're invited to ponder these mysteries, to give thanks and to adore Christ in his abiding Eucharistic presence. As I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do. May it be so.
If those to have their feet washed would come forward and sit in one of the chairs, take off one sock and one shoe.
My brothers and sisters, as God has given us the example of humble service in his Son, let us unite our prayers and our worship with Christ for the good of the church, the needs of the world, and the salvation of all people.
For the church, united in this Eucharistic banquet of praise and thanksgiving with Pope Francis and our Bishop Paul, our bishops, priests, deacons, religious sisters and brothers, who are called to be an image of Christ's mercy in service and ministry, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In washing his apostle feet, Jesus has given us a model to follow in our care for others. We pray that in our every thoughts and action, we will be loyal followers of Christ, treating our brothers and sisters with care, kindness, honesty, and love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As we reflect on this night, when Jesus asked the apostle to stay awake with him, we pray that as Christians, we too will be vigilant and supportive of his message to a very troubled world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, in our world today, so many of us are hungry for spiritual nourishment. May we be always grateful for your giving of yourself at the Last Supper, and help us to appreciate the Holy Eucharist, which is celebrated in our church every day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
At this time, when Mary, our mother, suffered the loss of her beloved Son, we remember in our prayers for all the mothers and fathers of those in the past year have suffered the loss of children and loved ones. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the spirit of wisdom, for leaders in the search of peace and hope for the people of the Holy Land in Ukraine, and for all Christians unable to celebrate the Eucharist this night because of illness, violence, and persecution. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We bow our heads and remember in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We glorify you, O God of the covenant, along with your Son, for through him we have salvation, life, and resurrection. Renew the power of this mystery in our service to one another, so that with Christ we may pass from this life to the glory of your kingdom, where you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and me, your unworthy servant, and all those who holding to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith, remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
Celebrating the most sacred day on which our Lord Jesus Christ was handed over for our sake, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogenus, John and Paul, Cosmos and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers and all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you as we observe this day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O Lord, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, for our salvation and the salvation of all, that is, today, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands and with eyes raised to heaven, you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the signs of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. We await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy of my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so may we enjoy his banquet for all eternity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.